I am Dr. Mohammad Atikur Rahman, Assistant Professor of Dermatology, Boshundhara Adin Medical College. Our today's lecture is cutaneous drug reaction. You know, drug is very essential component for health, but sometimes it produces some adverse effect that is called drug reaction. Especially, drug reaction can affect all the components of skin, maybe in hair, nail, or skin. Mucous membrane may also involve in case of drug reaction. When a drug reaction occurs in the skin, it may be exanthematous or rash. What is exanthema or rash? An exanthema is a generalized eruption consisting of inflammatory lesion is called exanthema. I repeat, a generalized eruption consisting of inflammatory lesion is called rash or exanthema. What is anathema? Anathema is mucous membrane lesion produced by a drug or viral infection. So, what is the difference? Exanthema occurs in the skin, that is cutaneous lesion. Generalized cutaneous eruption is called exanthema, and anathema always involve the mucous membrane, suppose coppery spot in case of measles. Coppery spot is anathema. Drug induced cutaneous lesion are very common. It may be exanthemas or articarial or pustular or bullous or even erythema multiforme like eruption can occur. In some case, there is diffuse sheet of skin may erupt, such as tan, toxic epidermolysis, in epidermolytic necrolysis. In hair, drug reaction may occur and there is alopecia. It may be diffuse alopecia, such as cytotoxic drugs induce alopecia, or there may be hypertrichosis, excessive hair growth due to drugs such as minoxidil induced hypertrichosis, cyclosporine or systemic steroid induced hypertrichosis. There is diffuse hair growth after taking the drugs, or there may be a pigmentary change of the hair due to drug reaction. So, if the drug reaction occurs in the hair, it may be alopecia, that may be diffuse alopecia or localized alopecia. It may be hypertrichosis, the excessive growth of the hair, or it may be pigmentary change of the hair shape, such as diazoxide or minoxidil induced pigmentary change. Drug reaction can occur also in the nail. It may produce onycholycosis. Onycholysis such as chemotherapeutic agent induced onycholysis, that is separation of the nail from the nail bed, falling of the nail, or it may produce onychomadesis, that is anti-neoplastic drug induced pigmentary change, or it may produce mis line, blues line, or thinning of the nail plate, subungual hyperkeratosis, nail fragility, nail dystrophy, etc., etc. There may be nail pigmentation also, such as minoxidil induced pigmentation, anti-malarial or PUBA therapy or chemotherapy induced nail pigmentation may occur. So if you summary the lesson, drug induced nail change are, number one is onycholysis, onychomadesis, mis line, Buse line, thinning of the nail plate, and subungual hyperkeratosis, nail fragility, and nail dystrophy. And the nail pigmentation also occur. Some form of drugs produce splinter hemorrhage, that is rare. And what are the skin change that is most important in drug reaction? Any type of skin lesion that is atypical should suspicion of a drug reaction. Remember that any skin lesion that is atypical to classical skin disease, it may be a drug eruption. Remember this. What may be the drug induced skin change? It may be exanthematous eruption. It may be hypersensitivity syndrome. It may be drug induced pseudo lymphoma. It may be articarial eruption or angioedema, or it may be photosensitive drug eruption. It may be skin necrosis, such as anticonvulsant induced skin necrosis. It may be lipodystrophy or lipohypertrophy. It may be pustular lesion. It may be pigmentary lesion, or it may be lichenoid eruption. Sometimes drug induced specific site hyperpigmented lesion following a bullous eruption, that is fixed drug eruption. Though the drug reaction is fixed to a particular drug and it produces fixed lesion, that is bullous followed by pigmentary change after every time of introduction of this drug to the human body. So it is called fixed drug eruption. That is, reaction is fixed and site of the skin is fixed, such as face or trunk. Every time this site is produce drug reaction when the particular type of drug is induced to the body, to the particular person. So it is called fixed drug eruption. It may be bullous drug reaction, such as Stephen-Johnson syndrome or toxic epidermal necrolysis. Toxic epidermal necrolysis or Stephen-Johnson syndrome, these are bullous drug eruption. Very much important. And there is some chemotherapy induced drug reaction may occur. And when the systemic involvement may occur in case of anaphylactic or anaphylactoid reaction, that is IgE mediated drug eruption, or non-IgE mediated drug eruption, there is systemic involvement. We know that it is called anaphylaxis. Certain drugs can produce anaphylactic or anaphylactoid reaction, such as penicillin, cephalosporin, or lidocaine or lignocaine, etc. That is very much troublesome. So the drug reaction may occur a wide range of coverage, for simple exanthema to severe form is anaphylaxis. So when we suspect a drug reaction, first one is if the drug is induced to human body within a few weeks of eruption of the drug, skin lesion. If the suspected drug is taken within a few weeks of appearance of the skin lesion, it may be hair lesion or nail change or skin pigmentation or skin exanthema, then it may be the cause of drug reaction. Any atypical skin lesion may cause a drug reaction. Certain drugs are the culprit, you know, certain drugs are culprit for drug reaction, especially number one is antibiotics. You know, the penicillin group are the culprit for drug reaction. Anaphylaxis is produced by penicillin. Or mild form of drug reaction may occur, cephalosporin or cotrimoxazole or nalidixic acid or metronidazole or any types of antibiotic can produce drug cutaneous adverse drug reaction, especially cotrimoxazole, cephalosporin, metronidazole, azithromycin, levofloxacin, etc. may produce drug reaction, ampicillin or amoxicillin. And next one is NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. You know, the painkiller may produce cutaneous drug eruption, especially the potent painkiller such as naproxen, diclofenac sodium or potassium may produce drug reaction. Mefenamic acid, etc. And third one is anticonvulsant drugs can produce drug reaction. And antihistamine even can produce drug eruption. Topical agent can also produce drug eruption, such as hair dye or topical medication for eczema or psoriasis. We use betamethasone with neomycin combination, it may produce cutaneous drug reaction. Sometimes systemic agent can produce phototoxic reaction within the body and it may produce drug eruption, such as doxycycline is an antibiotics. When it taken, it may produce phototoxic reaction of the food on the face and produce drug reaction. When on exposure to the solar photo allergen produce, and on sunlight it produce burning sensation on the face. So how we can diagnose the drug reaction? Number one is suspected drug should be stopped immediately. Management plan. First one is suspected drug should stop immediately. Number two is generalized measure for any cutaneous drug reaction, maybe a topical steroid may be given for inflammatory lesion, even a short course of systemic steroid may be given, antihistamine and suitable antibiotic for the cutaneous lesion to prevent secondary bacterial infection. And most important is patient aware of this, patient awareness for avoiding the suspected drug, that is the culprit for cutaneous drug reaction. And sometimes the skin lesions are spontaneously cured after stopping the drugs. So it may be a simple emollient or antihistamine may be beneficial for management plan. Sometimes it may produce severe life-threatening condition such as Stan or Stephen Johnson syndrome or anaphylaxis. It may produce a vigorous management, immediate management, airway clearance, breathing, circulatory support, and injectable steroid, adrenaline, etc., etc. So this is all about drug reaction. So in gist, if we summarize the lesson, number one is what is drug reaction? Any cutaneous eruption by a suspected drug may be a drug reaction which is atypical to any skin disease. It may be a drug reaction. Number two is if the suspected drug is induced to the body's surface within a week or within a month, it may be a drug reaction. Number three, how we manage the drug reaction? Number one is stoppage the drug and aware of this culprit drug for the next medication, and topical antibiotic and topical antihistamine or systemic antihistamine along with systemic antibiotic or systemic short course steroid may be beneficial for management plan. And next time we must avoid the suspected drug, or if we cannot avoid the drug, then we should give the alternative of same group of drugs, such as if the drug is NSAID, then we should prescribe not the naproxen but paracetamol, simple paracetamol double dose may subside the pain of the patient, not the naproxen. If the naproxen is culprit, we can avoid the naproxen sodium. We can simply give him paracetamol 500 milligram BD QDS for relief of pain. This is all about the cutaneous drug reaction, and thank you all for patience hearing.